What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to be showcasing version 2.0 of the XEB Plus Neutrino Loader plugin for the PlayStation 2. If you don't already know what that is, I'd suggest watching this video to get yourself caught up on the lore, but the TLDW is that XEB Plus is an advanced homebrew loader application for the PS2, and I've been developing a plugin for it that allows for loading game backups in a manner similar to other programs like OPL. I'm going to start off by showcasing the changes made in this new version, and then I'll go over the updated setup procedure. Let's get started. Now, the first and most significant new feature I've added with this update is support for both MX4SIO adapters and USB drives. Version 1 of this plugin only worked with the PlayStation 2 hard drive add-on, but now you can load ISOs from any of these three devices, and each one has its own entry on the XEB Plus dashboard. Though I will warn you that USB loading has some additional caveats that I'll get into during the setup portion. The Neutrino launcher settings have also been updated, with new toggles to hide launchers for devices you aren't using. These additions are an especially big deal for people who only have a PS2 Slim, as those don't work with the hard drive add-on. I know there's at least a few people who saw my last video and have been waiting for this update for that very reason. Another new feature this update adds is the ability to integrate with custom themes. If you're an XEB Plus theme developer, you can create your own versions of these four icons and add them to your theme directory. The plugin will automatically detect and load those icons in place of the ones it comes with, as long as the files are correctly named. Credit for this feature goes to Nuno6573, who both suggested it and provided most of the code for its implementation. There are also a number of other small improvements and quality of life features. I went through and fixed the majority of rendering and graphical hiccups the previous release had. The menu now looks much better, especially with themes that render a foreground layer on top of the menu items. I've also added an optional fade effect during background art transitions, and I need to thank HeroTex on the XEB Plus Discord for letting me reference his implementation of this same feature. Unfortunately, I was not able to improve the time it takes to cache artwork despite my best efforts. However, I did make the auto recache triggers less aggressive, so now it shouldn't ever refresh unless it actually needs to. I also made some improvements to the caching screen. Frame updates happen more often, so it no longer looks like the console was frozen for extended periods of time, and I've added a percentage counter. There's also one last big change this update makes that's not immediately obvious, but has major ramifications. I have completely overhauled the way in which games and their title IDs are detected and handled by the plugin. This is by far the most significant change from a technical perspective, and it's the reason that this update is version 2.0 instead of 1.something. This release is not directly compatible with prior ones, and if you attempt to update over an existing install without first removing the old plugin files, you're gonna have a bad time. You may recall from my previous video that XEB Plus cannot directly access data on any device other than the USB drive it's installed on. This is a significant limitation when you're trying to detect and load files that aren't on the USB drive, and the way I got around it originally was just to create a bunch of empty copies of all the game files on the USB drive and get the title IDs from their file names. This solution is kinda clunky and not really ideal. The main reason I stuck with it was because I wanted to keep this plugin from being reliant on PC-side utilities the way HDL is. Creating empty copies of files is universal to all operating systems, and something that most people can do by hand. The setup scripts I wrote were just there to speed up the process. Unfortunately, many of the features I wanted to add to this update just do not work well with such a basic solution. So I broke down and abstracted away the reference files into a list that the plugin reads on startup. Then I wrote a Python utility to generate that list. I even went the extra mile and created a nice graphical front end for it with the help of a friend. I made sure the actual list builder remained a pure command line tool that can be used completely independent of the GUI. That way people can more easily port it, make their own front ends, or integrate it into other software. All of which will hopefully make the reliance on a dedicated utility like this as painless as possible in the long run. Altogether, the PC side software accounted for more than half of the total development time spent on this update. While it was a lot of work to develop, tracking all the games in a list like this comes with some major advantages. First of all, the plugin no longer breaks OPL. It was pointed out to me that having a bunch of empty ISO files on the USB drive causes OPL to crash, and those are no longer needed. Managing separate game lists for all three devices the plugin now supports is much easier than it would have been otherwise. It's also faster to read a single file than it is to crawl through a directory, at least in theory, though in practice I didn't notice a difference there. The list is also what facilitated the new percentage counter I showed earlier. And last but certainly not least, this change allows game title IDs to be stored, tracked, and accessed separately from file names. This means that artwork can now be displayed for all games, regardless of what the file is called, and the PS2 title ID can be displayed in a separate field underneath the main title. The need to store title IDs in a separate field of the game list is a big part of why the list builder utility took so long to develop. There are already a number of tools out there that can associate PlayStation title IDs with an ISO file. However, as far as I can tell, these all work by just taking the file name and looking up a corresponding title ID in a database. That wasn't good enough for me. I wanted to pull the title ID directly out of the ROM data, which would both completely divorce the title ID from the file name and ensure 100% compatibility with the PS2 library. Things like utility disks, development builds, and homebrew software often have non-standard title IDs that aren't guaranteed to be in a pre-written database, but this method will find them. It took me several attempts to come up with a method of detecting title IDs that's both fast and accurate, but I did manage to get there in the end. A neat side effect of the detection method I landed on, combined with the way title IDs are stored in the ROM header, means that this list builder also works with PlayStation 1 games. The Neutrino launcher plugin can't actually use them, but if you need to extract a bunch of PS1 title IDs for some reason, this tool should do the trick. I think that covers all the major new changes and additions, so now let's go over the updated setup process. The first thing to do is make sure you have a recent version of Python installed on your computer. If you've previously installed an older version of the Neutrino Loader plugin, you'll also need to remove all its files from your XEB Plus folder before continuing. Here's a complete list of everything you need to remove. This is where the setup process deviates depending on what device you intend to load games from. If you're loading games from either a hard drive or MX4SIO, then you can boot XEB Plus pretty much however you want. Whatever bootloader and USB drive combo you use should be fine as long as you can get to the menu. However, if you want to load games from USB, then your options are much more limited. Last time I mentioned how I couldn't get the PS2 to read any flash drive larger than 4 GB. Well, that's still an issue, and a pretty big one for USB loading, considering most PS2 games are somewhere in the 1-4 GB range. Thankfully, it seems that limitation only affects FAT32 formatted drives. XFAT drives have no such restrictions. So just put your games on an XFAT drive and problem solved. Well, almost. The other limitation we have to contend with is that the PS2 can only read data from a single USB drive, so we can't just have a secondary drive with games on it like we do with the memory card and hard drive interfaces. That means that the XEB Plus install must be on the same drive as any games that are to be loaded from USB, and that means that the PS2 bootloader needs to be able to read XFAT drives. FreeMC Boot and its derivatives do not support XFAT. However, PS2 BBL does. So, if you want to load games from USB, you'll need to first set up a PS2 BBL memory card if you haven't already done so. The PS2 BBL setup process is outside the scope of this video, but I'll link some resources in the description. What I do need to mention, though, is that unless you configure PS2 BBL to boot directly into XEB Plus, you will also need to use a special version of WLaunchElf that has XFAT support. I've actually switched to using PS2 BBL full-time since working on this project, and I'd honestly recommend it over FreeMC Boot, even if you don't need XFAT support. Now we can finally get into the actual setup process. Start by connecting your game drive to the computer and formatting it as XFAT, whether that be a hard drive, SD card, or USB. Then get XEB Plus set up on your USB drive if you haven't already done so. Once that's done, you'll want to grab the latest version of the Neutrino Launcher plugin from the link in the description, and extract the XEB Plus folder to the root of your USB drive, merging any folders if prompted. You may also want to set up artwork files in your XEB Plus/GME/art folder. Next, you'll want to create folders named CD and DVD on the root of your game drive, and copy all your ISOs into the appropriate directory. So far, this is all nearly identical to the setup process for version 1, and these steps have all been covered in much more detail in my prior video, so I'm going to move on to the part that's substantially different. Once you have XEB Plus on your USB drive, and all your games have finished copying to your device of choice, go ahead and extract the list builder folder from the plugin package to a known location on your computer. Run gui.py with Python, and the list builder interface should open. Now you can create your games list. I'm demonstrating this part on Windows, because I think Windows drive letters make what's going on here just a little clearer. Start by selecting your drive type up at the top, and then click the first Choose Directory button. In the file dialog that pops up, browse to the directory containing your CD and DVD folders with all your games. This will almost certainly be the root of whatever drive you just copied them all to. Next, click the second Choose Directory button, and browse to the location of your XEB Plus folder, which should be the root of your USB drive. If you select USB as your drive type, then the second dialog will be grayed out and will autofill with the same location as the first one. That's because everything should be on the root of the USB drive in that case. Once you've got your drive selected, click Build List and wait for the process to complete. It should go pretty quick, and the console window will display a helpful error message if the utility can't find any of the folders it needs. If the process finishes successfully, you can close out the list builder, eject your drives, and hook everything back up to the PS2. After that, you should be good to go. One thing to note here is that if you're using an MX4SIO, it needs to be inserted into memory card slot 2. If you want to add or remove games later, just plug both drives back into your computer and run the list builder again after making changes to your CD and DVD folders. Using the loader plugin is pretty much the same as before, except it has a bit more polish and there are a couple of new settings that control what metadata is shown on the menu. Also, when a game is in your favorites list, the title will now change to look like this instead of showing the word favorite underneath. I think that's pretty much it for this update, but before I go, there's a few things I want to address. Since my last video, a user by the name of MegaBitmap has created a fork of version 1.01 of this plugin that loads games from a network share. I was hoping to add network loading at some point anyway, so it's super cool to see someone else taking the lead on that front. With this most recent update, the plugin now contains a framework for loading games from multiple sources, so hopefully it won't be too difficult to take that network loader implementation and roll it into a future release. I also need to make a correction. Previously, I referred to the lead XEB Plus developer as Chelsea, as this is the Discord account they were using. Turns out this account actually belongs to their wife. Howling Wolf is the actual lead XEB Plus developer, and the one who gave me access to the source code last time. So big thank you to him, and I hope I got that all right this time. Also, this channel recently passed 1,000 subscribers, so big thank you to everyone who helped make that happen. I actually did not expect to hit that milestone before this video was complete, but my last upload about the PS2 Noctua fan really popped off. I'm glad everyone seemed to like it so much. And of course, I once again need to thank everyone involved with the XEB Plus and Neutrino projects for their contributions, as well as everyone who found bugs and gave feedback on the first release of the Neutrino loader plugin. You guys have been great to work with, and your collective feedback has drastically altered the direction I took with this update. Shout out to the XEB Plus Discord server, subscribe to this channel if you want to see future updates on this thing, and I'll see you guys later.